come back with Sermon 7. And what I was talking about here is that we need to be looking at the fact is that you can give your life to Jesus Christ. See, looking back at this, we're looking at in Luke 3. When all the people were being baptized, Jesus was baptized too, and he was praying. And the heavens were opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him. So this is Luke 3, verses 22 on him. And the bodily form like a dove, and the voice came from heaven. You are my son, who I love with you, and I'm well pleased. And of course, I'm not going to go into this, but now Jesus himself was about 33 years old when he began his ministry, and he was a son, so he was fourth of Joseph. And so the simple fact is what I'm saying is that after he received the Holy Spirit, he went out into the desert. And he went out in the desert for 40 days, and he was tempted by the devil. But he was gathering strength. He knew what his father, he was listening to his father, he knew what his father wanted. You know, at the end of the day, can you gather strength? Can you realize that Jesus loves you? And that when you give your life to Jesus Christ, he has given you a commission. He's given you a purpose. And depending on what your purpose is, or what your purpose is, and seeking the purpose that God has foreknowledge and knowing beforehand, having a purpose. Basically, what is your purpose? What is your purpose tonight? Is it to be a school teacher? Is it to be serving as a teacher? Is it to be serving as somebody in the church? Is it to be serving as a nurse or a doctor or what have you? It could be any sort of purpose. What is your purpose? What is your fruit? What has Jesus given you the talents for? At the end of the day, what we've got to look at is that when you give your life to Jesus Christ and you say, I accept fully Jesus Christ in my heart, and your old self passes away and your new self begins, and you're reborn in Jesus Christ, that when you have accepted the Holy Spirit and accepted Jesus in your life, the Spirit of the Lord is on me. The Spirit of the Lord is on Jesus at this time, and the Spirit of the Lord is on you, because you have accepted Jesus Christ in your life. He has set me proclaiming the freedoms for prisoners and recovered the sight for the blind. He set you free. Amen. He has set you free. So if we look at the verse 40, so if we going on, if Jesus is gathering strength. If we look at Luke 4, as I said, Jesus was tempted, but he was still gathering strength. Jesus was gathering strength even by praying, listening to the Spirit, listening to the Holy Spirit. That's the key. You know, we go on in life and we don't listen. Meaning we don't listen to our inner selves. We don't listen to that inner voice. We don't listen to the Holy Spirit. And when we tend to be praying, we tend to be reading our Bibles and all this. But this is what a pastor one day said to me. We also need a notepad to write down our ideas, but we also need a second notepad so we can write down our vision. Because sometimes our vision that we have tend to be forgotten. They get dismissed out of our minds, but if we write them down and we actually listen, sometimes these visions can be from the Holy Spirit. And this is where you gather strength and you're praying and you're listening to God and you're reading your Bible and you're fellowshipping and doing all these things, that you can determine what these visions and these things that you're hearing. You'll know that from the Holy Spirit. But if you go back to what I'm saying before, if we looked at Luke 24, 22 verses 46. So we go back to Luke 22. And we go back to Luke 22 verses 46. Why are you sleeping out? Get up and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. Jesus is saying to his disciples. He's saying to you, why are you sleeping? Why are you sleeping? We don't mean you're actually sleeping in bed. Sleeping is where you're walking around this world. You're confused. You're dazed. You're allowing temptation. You are not gathering strength enough. You're not praying. You're not reading your Bible. And you're walking around asleep. Why are you sleeping? So in this case, yes, the disciples were sleeping. And they were full of sorrow. And Jesus comes back and he says, why are you sleeping? He asks them, get up and pray so you will not fall into temptation. He's urging us to get up and pray so we don't fall into temptation. And when we start praying, we have that communication with the Holy Spirit and we start to realize that we can gather strength. So So Jesus was gathering strength even by praying, listening to the Spirit. But if we go back to what we're saying before, if we look at Luke 22 verses 46, as we're saying, we are sleeping. He's asked us to get up and pray so you will not fall into temptation. I think that's what we need to do. We need to get up and pray so we are warned that we won't fall into temptation. See, the disciples lost their focus and they were not gathering strength. They fell asleep and did not listen. In Thessalonians 5 verses 9 and 11, they to pray and allow not the temptation to creep in. So Jesus was always praying and gathering strength. He is accepting his faith and listening to the Spirit and his Father in heaven. So what I will conclude tonight with, are we accepting Jesus? Are we 100% accepting Jesus? Are we listening to the Holy Spirit? Jesus was, and we see on the hour that Jesus was gathering strength, and he was happy. It's a bit strange. I mean, if you knew that on the hour that you were going to be arrested, that you knew you were going to be betrayed, you knew this was going to happen, these Roman soldiers were going to come and arrest you, and really all this confusion and etc., you knew this was going to be happening. Jesus knew this was going to happen, but he accepted his fate. He accepted what his Father had in heaven, and he was happy. He was relaxed. He knew that this was his fate, and he accepted it. And by accepting Jesus Christ into your heart, you're no longer fighting. You know, imagine if Jesus did not accept this and he was not gathering strength and he was going to fight the Romans and all the rest of it, we wouldn't have Jesus. Jesus wouldn't have died on the cross. He was willing to accept his Father's will. He was willing to be crucified, that his blood would be shed for all of us. He knew that by shedding his blood that we all have the opportunity to come to Jesus and say, we are sinners, please forgive us, we accept you into our hearts, and we ask you to be our Lord and Saviour. See, he was gathering strength, he was happy. Jesus was praying, studying God's word, listening to the Holy Spirit, listening to his Father, accepting his lot and his faith, preaching the good news. And what I'd like to do in concluding, I'd like to read 1 Timothy 1 verses 12 and 20. Being there feels for God's it's sort of about God's kindness and having that feel for God's kindness. So I want to go to read 1 Timothy 1 verses 12 and 20, and I'll do this in the next sermon after this.